This is Sirdia, and today the book I'm going to be discussing is a book by Richard Wiseman, Rip It Up. This book is amazing. This book taught me a lot of things I didn't knew beforehand, and this book I recommend any who want to change his behavior and change his lifestyle and all of those things. From happiness in a workplace and environment to happiness in our personal space. He talks about the things that change and alter our behaviors and almost alter our emotions and lead us to unhappy life. He tells us that after doing all of those experiments, he says that first, what we forget to have a happy life, we forget that our behaviors influence our emotions. Many of the courses are there in the market to make you have positive life, positivity in you, and those things target towards thinking about having a thing, like thinking about being happy and then becoming happy. He said that those things are absolutely necessary, there is no problem in that, but those things take time. But as you know, life is short, and what we are ought to do is make things speed up, right? So here is the three levels. First level is your environment, second is your behavior, third is your thoughts and emotions, right? If you can control your environment, then you are controlling your behavior indirectly, and that is ultimately controlling your emotions. Now if your environment is happy and positive, then your behaviors are going to be positive, and at last your emotions are going to be positive. But once your environment is not right, then your behaviors and ultimately your emotions will be negative, and this will lead to an unhappy life. There are so many restrictions we have, like most of us can't change the environment suddenly. So what we can do is leave the environment behind to tackle with it later. Now change the behavior first. If you want to be happy, make a fake smile, like have a smile in your face, right? And this is proved, right? Like many participants are brought to have a psychological experiment. They were divided into two groups, and one group was told to do a job after making a fake smile. Another group had like an unhappy face, and they were asked to do the same thing that the people were that are having a fake smile were to do. So the results came as well as we know that the ones who had a fake smile had amazingly happy behavior in the job they did, and those who didn't who had an unhappy face performed just like as we expected. They were negative and all those things. So not only about fake smile, he talks about everything from eating disorders to persuasion and everything. Like if you want to change your thoughts, be happy all the time, then you will be happy. You have to do these things, like change your behavior. So what I want to tell you that if I were to tell you everything, and I do know everything, if that were the case, like I do know everything, then I wouldn't be telling you to read this book. It is one of the masters, and you can learn a great deal of that. He has some more books that you can practice in your daily life, and it is great to have that. I was lucky enough to read this book, and now I am sharing with you.